sometimes emotions and different things can take over, which would cause you to do things that you normally wouldn't. Currently, how many concealed permit holders do we have in the audience tonight? I'd say just about half. How many carry every day? How many are carrying right now? That's normally the response I get. I see there's a lot of concealed permit holders, probably half the audience. And I'd say probably a tenth of those carry every day, and probably 1% of that carry right now. So if somebody comes in, who's going to protect me? Where's Aileen? She's probably got her. The Castle Doctrine, stand your ground law in the state of Florida. There is a representative currently. Actually, there's probably 50 gun bills right now, just for this year, that would change the current protection as we know it, such as the Castle Doctrine, the stand your ground law. There is a representative that would like to remove the immunity from criminal and civil liability for certain uses of deadly force in that situation. If you did have to protect yourself, in their eyes, they want to hold you responsible for that. Also, there are current provisions that allow a person to stand his or her ground to meet force with force in certain circumstances, but not to apply to the person that initiates that threat or that may trail or follow you where death may have occurred in that incident. In addition, there's also a senator that would like to repeal the Castle Doctrine and stand your ground law relating to home protection and the use of deadly force in your home. And I'm sure everyone here would agree that if someone broke into your home in the middle of the night uninvited and you're in fear for your life, you better use your gun. There are several ways to defend yourself against any kind of attack in your home, whether it be lethal or non-lethal, as we talked about, pepper gas, stun guns, tasers, even a simple devices like wasp spray. Everyone has one under the kitchen sink or in the garage. You know, that stuff can shoot 25 feet, and it's very potent, allows you to get away from a threat if the need be. A knife, also to include a firearm. You know, lethal form of defense is always a last resort, and I'm probably like everyone here. I would never want to have to use a firearm if I had to protect myself, my wife, my family, my employees at the establishment. I probably wouldn't think twice about it. In the state of Florida,